earlier, they used to call this transistor as a point contact transistors. They used to call it as a point contact transistors. Then by the knowing about the term about bipolar, they have switched to that advantage of bipolar, and they have named it as a bipolar junction transistor, which was invented in the early 1948. And because of this one, initially known as a simple junction transistor, it did not become practical until the early 1950s. The term bipolar was tagged onto the name of a distinguished fact that both the carrier part types play the important role in the operation. Bipolar means both the two types of carriers have been very much useful in the operation of the bipolar BJT transistors. That's why they have named it as a bipolar. And the field effect transistors are the unipolar transistors, since their operation depends upon primary of only single carrier type. That's a major that's a major difference between the BJT and the FETs. Whereas the BJTs mainly depends upon the operation of the two poles, that's a two polar or nothing else but two carrier types. But whereas the FETs, that's a FET, depends upon only the operation of unipolar or the single carrier type. Coming to what is meant by BJT. BJT is nothing else but it's a bipolar PN junction diodes. It will be having the two PN junction diodes which are connected back to back. If you can connect a back to back PN junction diodes, that particular concept is called as a BJT. There are like two kinds of BJTs. We know that there's a NPN BJT and also the PNP BJT. So these are the two major types of BJTs. And this particular BJT, in this BJT, there are three different layers, which are nothing else but called as in three terminals, which are sandwiched in order to get conventionally, which are called as a collector, base, and emitter. So these are three main terminals of the BJT. So let us now see what is meant by BJT. We have seen what is meant by BJT. And let us now see BJT fabrication. Let us see how the BJT fabrication has been done, and this BJT fabrication has been done with by keeping in mind the NPN device. And coming to the first process, BJT fabrication process steps. In this BJT fabrication process steps, there are like nine different fabrication steps are there. The first one is a implantation of the buried N plus fabrication. N plus fabrication. And next will be the growth of a epitaxial layer. And next is a P plus isolation diffusion. Next is a base P plus diffusion, emitter N plus diffusion. Next is a P plus ohmic contact will be created. And seventh is a contact etching, metal deposition and etching. Ninth is a passivation and bond pad opening. So these are the major nine steps in this BJT fabrication. So let us see now one after the other. What is meant by implantation of the buried N plus layer? So what is meant by buried N plus layer? For any of the NPN transistor, which is most common type of fabricated in a commonly fabricated in a IC, the N-type layer serves as a collector here. The N-type layer will be serving as a collector. In order to reduce this collector resistance in the path between the epitaxial collector region and the surface, a region of highly doped, that's nothing else but we are talking about the high conductive part. This high conductive N-type of material has been created beneath this epitaxial layer, which is and also another form of epithelial layer is also been created, which acts as a contact to the collector. And this contact, this N-type region, we call it as a buried layer. And this buried layer is nothing else but this layer will be created almost inside of this P-substrate. Inside the P-substrate, nearly like, it will be created like 10 to 15 units into that particular P-substrate. So that's why we call it as a buried one. So that's the main term. That's why they have used a term called buried N plus layer. And later after that one, the growth of epitaxial layer will be created upon this the entire one upon this entire P subset and N type of epitaxial layer has been created. Later upon this, after growing of this epitaxial layer, we'll be creating the P plus isolation layer on the both the sides of this complete design. And P plus isolation layer is mainly used as a name itself. It tells that it isolates the entire design, or else it will protect the entire design from any kind of, from further deposition of the impurities, or else for further deposition or getting harm to the particular structure from any other further layer deposition. So that's why it is called as a P plus isolation layer. And after this one, we'll try to create a base of P type diffusion. It means that here you'll be etching off again. Every time it will be like if you want to create any new step, wherever you want to create that one, we'll be removing the further step layer and we'll be etching it off. And then we'll be depositing the what kind of layer we want. Here we need the P-type diffusion. So that's why in the previous part, we have etched off this region and then we'll be doping it with the P-type of diffusion in order to form it as a P-base. So that's how the base has been created. Then later, upon the P base, we need to create the emitter N-type diffusion. N plus diffusion will be created here on this P base. We'll be again depositing the N-type of impurities in order to form it as an N plus layer. And later, after creating use for the emitter purpose, we'll be again going for creating of P plus ohmic contact. This P plus ohmic contact is one contact will be done between this P base and also for the P plus impurities where you'll be again filled into this particular step in order to form the next layer. So that's a P plus ohmic contact. And after that one, onto this one, you will be making the contact etching will be done. Contact etching has been done. This is how the contact etching have been done in this all the three regions. Then after this one, the metal deposition will be done. The metal deposition means what will be again, will be etching of this region wherever you want the metal to be deposited. So after the etching the region, in that particular region itself, the masking will be done. And after masking, the particular material or metal tag will be deposited here. And it is like a metal deposition, and also later it will be etching will be done. And on to this one, the entire again isolation layer has been created on this particular region of the metals. So this is how your entire lateral view of a NPN BJT looks. So this is a top view of the BJT, where you can see the different types of there's a P region. Again, the P type of contact has been done. Upon the P type of contact, we can see the contacts which have been created. So this is a complete top view. And this is a side view. You can see that P plus isolation region is there. Again, this N plus region, N plus emitter, this is a P base and P plus region, and this is N plus region. This is a collector. So you can have the three type of terminals of the NPN transistor. There's a collector, base, and emitters have been created. This is how the three different terminals of the NPN transistors have been created. And this is a passivation, which is mainly used to protect this one. It's like a protective layer has to be created upon the entire device or the transistor from the any kind of environmental hazards or any kind of environmental attacks onto this particular device. So this is a lateral view of the NPN BJT. These are from another part. This is a top view and a side view of a PNP BJT. The previous one was an NPN BJT, and this is a side view and top view of the PNP BJT. Here you can see that in the NPN BJT, you'll be having like P base, N plus emitter, and N collector. When it comes to this part, you can see that N base, P collector, and a P emitter. So this is a PNP BJT, and the previous one was an NPN BJT. And this, let us talk now few things regarding the impurity concentration profile of the BJT. In this impurity concentration, you can be concentration in a centimeter per centimeter cube. coming to this emitter part, you can have like a N plus region where the impurities can be up to like 10^20 per centimeter cube for the emitter region. This many impurities, N type of impurities can be used, will be used for creating of this particular region. For base part here, you'll be using like the impurities will be like from 10^18 to 10^15, depending upon the what kind of terminal you are supposed to use for which operation you are using that one. And here, these are the impurity concentration for the base one. And for the collector one, the doping level for the collector, it depends like it is a constant for like 10^15 per centimeter cube impurities have been used for the collector region. And coming to the buried layer, when it talks about the buried layer here, the impurities will be like 10^18 impurities have been used per centimeter cube impurities have been used. And talking about the substrate, in order to form the substrate, then again the substrate doping is constant, which is like 10^18. And we should always keep in mind for a BJT, the constant part of the substrate is like 10^18 impurities have been used per centimeter cube, and for the collector it is 10^15. These two will be constant for the BJT, whereas this one, the emitter base and this part, the buried layer, depends upon the operation of that particular, for which operation you are trying to use and where you are using that BJT. So this is how the impurities have been used in order to form the BJT.